Hi, everyone. My name is Nick Stiles with Fukuoka Now Magazine, and today I am at the PayPay Dome in Fukuoka City. And this normally is a really busy place around Golden Week because of all the home games that the Hawks are normally playing, but unfortunately, the Japanese Professional League is on a bit of a hold now. However, the players are still practicing inside, and today we're going to speak with two of the international players on the Hawks team. And first up, we have Rick Vandehurk. Hi, Rick.
Nice. Thank you for having me, man. Thank you for having me on the show. It's awesome.
Good to see you. I haven't seen you in a long time. You're looking well.
Thank you so much. Yeah, you're looking good yourself.
Well, I know you have some big personal news.
Yes, about 6 months ago, my son was born right here in Fukuoka. My wife and my son, Ryan, they're doing great and in great condition. And his rapid growth has stunned me. He's crawling. He's eating already some carrot and broccoli and zucchini. And it's been such a blessing.
Has becoming a father, has that changed how you are on the field?
Yeah, it definitely has. You know, it shifts your priorities. That's definitely for sure. Now all the time that you have, it's so precious. You know, spending that with your family, and so that has definitely been, I think, the biggest change as far as on the field. With everything going on, everything is up in the air. We're not sure what's going on really. Keep postponing. We just try to prepare ourselves as best as possible and just stay ready for when the call does come. We're ready to go.
Yeah, well, and then you've got all this time to teach your son how to throw.
Yeah, well, definitely handing him over some baseballs and like little toys to play with. So if he's going to throw the ball, that's fine with me.
So with all this time off, though, seriously, what else are you doing?
I try to focus on my health a bit. Try to get some eating patterns right and my diet, you know, master that a little bit better. Sleeping patterns, you know, is very important, especially nowadays with all the devices and stuff that can disrupt some of your patterns as well. So I'm trying to focus on that a little bit and dial it in. And then other than that, you know, enjoy time with the family, go for walks around the neighborhood. And just try to talk to our family back home and make sure that they are okay. And yeah, things like that.
Are you gotten hooked on any TV series or something?
I'm watching The Last Dance right now. It's a basketball documentary on Netflix with Michael Jordan and the Bulls. And it's definitely a must. It's awesome. It's really awesome. So as far as watching movies and documentaries and stuff, I haven't had that much time, you know, because I'm just spending a lot of time with my family and raising my son. So, and that new lifestyle as well.
Since the shutdown began, you must be missing many things besides baseball. Is there something in Fukuoka City or somewhere that you miss not going to?
Well, we try, when we go now to certain places, we try to go where it's not very crowded. So we try to stay away a bit from downtown, which, you know, sometimes it's nice to go there. Ohori Park, for instance, you know, I know the parking lots there are closed and some of the playgrounds are closed, so we're not going there. So there are a few places, you know, we like to go to that we're not. And just try to be safe and try to, you know, make sure our part in social distancing and making sure we you know, attack it the correct way. So, yeah. And then, of course, the family part, you know, most of the time, every month, some families flying in. And that has been on hold as well because of the being closed and also the corona, the COVID-19 going on in the Netherlands. So, yeah.
Any advice for the other foreigners here in Fukuoka?
As far as travel-wise or enjoying and having a good day, I would definitely go around Fukushima. I think it's not as busy. Maybe now with Golden Week, I'm not sure how packed it is, but before it wasn't as packed. Sometimes you like to go into the mountains as well. You know, around Fukushima, there's beautiful mountains. It's not crowded at all. So we just take a walk in the woods or, you know, try to look up a waterfall or something like that. And as far as restaurants go, we kind of eat inside now. We just cook at home and try to stay in. Yeah.
All right. Finally, any message to the Hawks fans?
We can't wait to get back into the dome and have the atmosphere with you guys. You know, it's it's really weird being here and practicing and going about. There's nobody in the stand. You know, it's such a huge part of our team, and you know, we look forward to having more great memories together and a fight to win another championship. So
we're looking forward to seeing you back on the field as well too. So thanks a lot for joining us today.
All right, thank you so much, Nick, and hopefully see you.